Myself, Praveen Kumar Chaturvedi, Service Senior Resident from Regional Institute of Ophthalmology, Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi. I am presenting on correlation of ankle brachial index and diabetic retinopathy in type 2 diabetes patients. Various studies have reported the association of a microangiopathy with the markers of the macroangiopathy, like diabetic retinopathy, microangiopathy, and the peripheral vascular disease of macroangiopathy. Among these markers is the basic one is the ankle brachial index, a simple non-invasive method of determining the presence of peripheral arterial disease or macrovascular complication. And the aim of this study is to correlate ankle brachial ABI index with the severity of diabetic retinopathy. Though well studied, this topic is well studied, but the results are varied. This is an interdisciplinary hospital-based prospective study comprising of 100 patients with age group of 40 to 80 years, predefined inclusion criteria of age more than 14 years, giving consent, and having a diabetic on a glucose test, and exclusion criteria for age less than 14, other causes of raised blood sugar level or like metabolic syndrome, and other causes of peripheral vascular disease like Burgess disease and calcific vessels. All underwent ankle brachial index measurement and the color Doppler ultrasound for standardization. And the ABI score of less than 0.9 was the cutoff used for diagnosis of PVD. The statistical analysis was done. And the male to female ratio in our study was 3:2, with a mean age of around 60 years of age, as shown in the bar diagram. And the mean age of duration was around 8 years, a standard deviation of 1.5 years, as shown. Among all the cases, 22% were having diabetes less than 5 years of duration, where only 2% cases were having diabetes more than 15 years of duration. The parameter of the cases as shown on the left side is a brachial, ankle brachial index with abnormal ABI and normal ABI. And on right-hand side is the color Doppler ultrasonography compared for mild to moderate diabetic retinopathy patients and severe diabetic retinopathy patients. In abnormal ABI, those having normal color Doppler and abnormal color Doppler, they are shown. And also distribution for ABI, normal and abnormal, given right-hand side corner below in bar diagram. This statistical test that has been used is chi-square test for the data. And the chi-square, uncorrected chi-square came to be 7.8 with a statistically significant. Yates correction were also significant, and the Fisher exact is also significant in this test. There is an odds ratio of 4.1. There is a 4 times probability of having the test of detection of abnormal ABI as compared to the mild to moderate and severe diabetic retinopathy. And when the ABI was compared with the gold standard color Doppler ultrasonography, the sensitivity of the test came to be 68.4% and specificity of 92.59% with a high negative predictive value of 92.59%.
3 minutes over.
Diagnostic accuracy is 88%. And the conclusion is that the patient with abnormal ABI were more likely to have severe diabetic retinopathy and were at increased risk of losing their sight, therefore mandating fundus evaluation in such cases. Thank you.